This is Acer Swift 5, a thin and light notebook that I have been using for over a month now. This laptop is a part of Intel's Evo platform, which promises a thin and light form factor, long battery life, and a kick-ass performance. So in today's video, I will give my detailed review of this laptop, Technopanda style. By the way, you can find more details about the pricing and availability of this laptop by clicking the country-specific links that I have put in the video description below. So without further ado, let's get started. Acer Swift 5 is a premium laptop sporting an all-metal construction. So the chassis is made from high-grade magnesium lithium and magnesium aluminium alloy, which keeps its weight down while still providing a good structural rigidity. Swift 5 weighs only 2.2 pounds or 1 kilogram, which makes it feather-light when holding it in your hands. So in a sea of silver, gray, and black-colored laptops that have flooded the market in recent years, the mist green colored Acer Swift 5 stands out from the crowd. Its Acer logo on the top lid carries a signature metallic copper bronze vibe that nicely complements its metallic hinges. Open the laptop and you are greeted with the same copper bronze metallic color scheme. So the keyboard is using bronze lettering on mist green keycaps, which is a truly unique color combo that gives this laptop a very premium flair. I think Acer Swift 5 will surely turn heads whether you are using it in a coffee shop or a classroom. Moving on to the display, so you are getting a 14-inch Full HD touchscreen display. It's an LED backlit IPS panel pumping out 340 nits of peak brightness. Guys, this is a really bright screen. I had no trouble using it in my home in various lighting environments. So the screen delivers 100% sRGB color gamut, which makes it a great laptop choice for digital artwork, photo editing, and color grading. I love its narrow bezels, which deliver an impressive 90% screen to body ratio. So this is a glossy screen with excellent contrast ratio and impressive color reproduction, making it a perfect screen for watching multimedia contents. Now you can tilt the screen to about 150 degrees, providing more than enough room to comfortably use this laptop on a desk or if you are seated in a couch or a bed. But guys, note that this is not a 2-in-1 laptop, so you cannot flip the screen all the way back 360 degrees, unlike some of the other 2-in-1 laptops. So that's kind of a bummer. But overall, I think Acer has put a really high quality display on Swift 5, making this laptop a pleasure to use. Swift 5 comes with a backlit-enabled chiclet-style keyboard that offers decent key travel and a springy feedback. The backlighting can be completely turned off if you want to preserve the battery life. I like the thoughtful refinements that Acer has added to this keyboard. So for example, when you open the laptop screen, its hinge lifts the laptop base by a few millimeters, and this creates a nice ergonomic typing position. Also, the most commonly used keys like the Control, Alt, and Shift keys, they are bigger in size, and this helps with touch typing. Now the bronze lettering on mist green keycaps, it provides a nice contrast for easy typing in both brightly lit rooms as well as dark rooms. Okay, let's talk about the trackpad, which measures 4.25 by 2.5 inches. So this is a really high quality trackpad with glass-like surface, and it feels incredibly smooth when scrolling, swiping, and executing various Windows 10 gestures. There are no annoying rattling or wobbling sound, and it generates satisfying clicks. Swift 5 comes with a fingerprint sensor that is located right below the arrow keys, and this is great for passwordless login. My review unit is powered by an Intel Core i7 1165 G7 processor, and it comes with 16 GB LPDDR4 RAM and 1 TB of PCIe NVMe SSD. There is a cheaper Core i5 configuration that comes with 8 GB RAM, and it comes with 512 GB SSD storage. So the RAM is soldered to the motherboard, and unfortunately you cannot upgrade it, but the PCIe NVMe SSD, it can be easily upgraded by opening the back of the laptop. Now, as I mentioned before, Acer Swift 5 is a part of Intel's Evo branding, which promises thin and light body, great CPU and GPU performance, and at least 9 hours of battery life. Now guys, in my testing, my review unit has consistently exceeded these claims. In fact, I'm getting 12 hours of battery life on a normal day use, which I think is insane for a Windows laptop. Now the Core i7 processor, it's a beast, and it delivers absolutely blazing performance. Here is the Cinebench single core benchmark, and you can see that this chip towers above its competition. The integrated Intel Iris Xe graphics is also pretty good for casual gaming and for watching 4K streaming videos from YouTube, Hulu, you know, Netflix, and all other streaming services. To check the CPU performance and the thermals on this laptop, I stress tested this laptop by running a prime number extraction algorithm, which maxes maxes out all the 4 cores and 8 threads in this laptop. So in my test, the CPU ran at turbo boost clock frequency of 3.8 GHz in the beginning before it settled to 3.5 GHz. That is still much higher than the base clock frequency, which is 2.8 GHz. The CPU never throttled or slowed down thanks to Swift 5's excellent thermal design that incorporates dual copper pipes for adequate cooling. So guys, in summary, this laptop can easily handle day-to-day tasks, so stuff like internet surfing, creating documents and Excel sheets, as well as complex tasks, so stuff like, you know, software development, video editing, running apps like Adobe Photoshop. All these tasks can be very easily accomplished on this laptop. Acer Swift 5 shows how it's possible to create a stylish looking thin and light laptop without compromising on the ports. So you are getting a USB Type-C Thunderbolt 4 port that supports up to 10 gigabits per second data transfer speed, as well as 65 watt power delivery for rapid battery charging and the ability to drive a 4K monitor at 60 Hz refresh rate. In addition, there is an old school HDMI port that can also drive an external 4K monitor. So that means you can connect two external 4K monitors to this laptop, and that will create a kick-ass home office workstation. You also get a USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A port along with support for latest Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth standards. Now this laptop comes with a large 56 watt-hour battery that can easily power this laptop for 12 hours. The included battery charger also supports fast charging, so you can easily add extra 4 hours of battery life by juicing this laptop for, you know, about 30 minutes. So let's quickly talk about the thermals. In my last 1 month of using this laptop, I have not experienced any overheating. In fact, the fans remain mostly quiet, and the only time where I heard this fan was when I was running the CPU benchmarking test, but for my normal day-to-day use, the CPU ran very cool and the fans were very quiet. Also, the keyboard and the trackpad never really got uncomfortably warm, even when running demanding tasks like, you know, video editing and some casual gaming. Let's quickly talk about the webcam, because odds are that you probably are, you know, indulging in Zoom conference calls. Most of us are still working from home. Unfortunately, guys, the webcam on this laptop, it's a mediocre 720p resolution webcam, and I'm a little disappointed with the quality of this webcam. Honestly, for a $100 laptop in 2021, I expected better. So if you want to step up the video quality, I would recommend getting an external 1080p USB webcam, and you don't have to go shell out a lot of money to get an expensive, you know, external USB webcam. There are some really good quality webcams selling for $30 to $40, which will dramatically improve the quality of your video calls. So I have linked some of my favorite 1080p webcams in the video description below, and you guys can check it out. Okay guys, so here is the bottom line. I think Acer Swift 5 is a fantastic thin and light laptop offering kick-ass performance, excellent battery life, and very good port connectivity. It has a solid all-metal construction, it has got a stylish design, you get a bright full HD IPS display, and there is good quality keyboard and trackpad. But guys, the elephant in the room is Apple's M1 MacBook Air, which also costs about the same, and it carries the Apple cache and arguably a better battery life and, you know, better performing chip. So then the $1 million question becomes, should you buy the MacBook Air or should you buy this Windows laptop? But there are some disadvantages with the Apple's MacBook Air. For example, it does not support a touchscreen display, so that may make it a non-starter for many Windows folks who love touch, you know, capability on their laptop. By the way guys, I plan to get an M1 MacBook Air here in the studio, and I want to do a full review of this laptop, so you can bet your ass that I will put these two laptops against each other for a Techno Panda style showdown. So please subscribe to this channel if you want to see that video, if you don't want to miss out on that action. So that's it for today guys. I hope you found this video useful. Please smash the like button. It helps with the YouTube algorithm and it helps with the, you know, the growth of this channel. So I will really appreciate if you like this video. Also check out technopandareviews.com, where I have consolidated all the reviews that I have done in the last couple of years. So guys, thanks again for watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.